Another banger.
Make a call, make a bong, bong, bong. Make a call, make a dream, but the bong, bong, bong. Your body, kakara. Make a bong, bong, bong. On a make it.
Kilo fait en mode de choc de Fine, fine, no bucket de Watch your love for like it, Why not more mode de
Welcome back to another video. For those of you who are new, I'm Muriette, but you can call me Mimi. Let's get into the video. So guys, I'm currently at the gym and we're about to get a workout in. Alright, so I know I said I wasn't gonna film me being a 6 a.m. girly again, but when I woke up this morning at like 4 o'clock in the morning, I just had the urge. I was like, I wanna record today. So that's what we're gonna do. But y'all, I try to be a 6 a.m. girly. Let me tell y'all what happened. So I woke up around 4, not by my might. It had to be God, because I literally felt myself stop dreaming. And then when I woke up, it was around like 4 in the morning. And all of a sudden, it was just raining really hard outside and stuff. And I was just like, ooh, the rain sounds like, I feel like God is telling me to go pray. Because usually, you know, those are warfare hours. If you're waking up in the middle of that time, you need to go like pray or whatever. But I was just like, the rain sounds like I just want to lay down. I want to go to sleep. So I'm going to go to sleep. I tried going to sleep, y'all. I struggled for like a good hour trying to go to sleep. And I could not go to sleep. Then eventually I fell asleep, right? And I get attacked in my sleep with sleep paralysis. And then I woke up. And that's when I just felt like the Lord was like, you know, go do your quiet time and stuff. And when I woke up, it was around like 6:10, so I was like, okay, well, at least we still waking up at 6 in the morning, right? So I get up, I'm in my quiet time. Y'all, when I tell you, I'm trying so hard to stay awake while doing my Bible reading and stuff. I end up falling asleep, and what's so crazy was I was telling in the girls in the meeting, in the ministry meeting that I'm in, I was like, you know, I feel like I've been on a good momentum with God. Like, I've been consistent in my word, like I've been reading day and night in my word and stuff like that. And I picked the book of Exodus to read because it's long, so it kind of like helps me stay consistent. And like, literally, I felt like I've been doing really good in my life. Like, I've been, you know, trying to achieve my goals and stuff, and I'm not letting anything stop me. And I'm like, I don't want to ruin the momentum I have with God. So all of a sudden, I'm starting to get sleepy while I'm reading the word, and I'm like, this has to be an attack. But y'all, I could not control it this morning. So I forgot my Apple Watch. It's currently like 10 something in the morning, so I kind of got a late start. But technically I didn't, but technically I did. Because, you know, we woke up at 4, went back to sleep, woke up at 6, went back to sleep, and now we're here at the gym. So not going to let the devil ruin my day. And we're here at the gym, and we're going to work out. So, all right, that's enough of me rambling, enough of me talking. Let's get into the video.
2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the beach? Early, baby, later, you can show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit. Sandy City, show me kisses. 30 degrees, way too cold, so hold me tight. Will I see you at the show tonight? Will I see you at the show tonight?
Hey. Truck to the plane, to the truck to the hotel lobby. Me, I go through underground garages, presidential suite on deposit. Elevator up to the room, shower up, and then we hit the club. Touchdown, gotta see what's up. Area code in my phone, what numbers do I still have? Who do I know from the past? Hit one, she say she got a man. Hit another one, it goes green. Must have changed foes on the team. Remember when you let me in between? That was 2017. All good, chug a look around. Find one to see my type. Yeah, my dog, and he know what I like. He done found me plenty in my life. Problem is, I meet a girl tonight. Then I go and treat her too nice. Got a real credit card swipes.
Hey, you guys. So, I got my smoothie. Don't mind the cup. We're sustainable here. but it's really, really good. So yeah, so basically we're gonna get started for today. Y'all don't mind my hair. Okay, I need to take my hair out like desperately, but I'm waiting because, you know, y'all see. So yeah, I'm gonna get into my work for today. I have a couple things to do today. I'm gonna reach out a to-do list. So today I tried to be like realistic with myself and everything. So today I had to put the burrito tacos to thaw out from Trader Joe's because we're gonna make that for dinner today. I already did that. I need to make a TikTok. I need to clean the hair combs and stuff because I have a client tomorrow. So I need to do that. Oh, I need to make sure I have enough product to do hair, because if not, I gotta go to the hair store. I need to redo my quiet time, child, because y'all already know what happened this morning. But yeah, and then I need to do schoolwork. See, yesterday I did most of my content stuff, but today I need to do school. Like, I have assignments to do. I need to do that. So yeah, y'all, working in like the mental health field, it's not easy. So one of our assignments, we had to like choose a movie or a TV show and basically pick a character out of that show, and we had to like, you know, come up with like a treatment plan for like their situation and stuff like that. The movie my group picked, and it's the reason I'm the one who picked it, because everyone in the group said they already seen this movie, and I was just like, I haven't seen it, so since everybody's seen it, I'll watch it and you guys can rewatch it, since you guys will already know and will be comfortable with it, like, you know, it'll be easy to do. Child, this movie was kind of heavy, like really heavy. It was about this like freshman in high school and how like his best friend committed suicide. Like, sorry for trauma dumping, but like his best friend committed suicide, then his auntie sexually assaulted him when he was younger and she got in a car accident, and he kind of blamed himself for her death. And then on top of that, he was dealing with PTSD and all this stuff. It was just a whole lot. And I'm just like, why did I pick this? Like, this is really heavy. But yeah, so my assignment is I have to make a genogram for him, and I have to come up with like some assessments and stuff. That's my portion of the project and stuff. So we're gonna do that. But yeah, that was a heavy movie. But yeah, but all right, I'm gonna stop rambling and I'm gonna get to work because we got some things to do. Oh, I also have to log off social media for 3 hours. All right, I'm gonna go, y'all. So what had happened was my laptop is dead. So I was like, my laptop is dead, I'm gonna let it charge. I don't want to use it while it's charging because then it's gonna overheat and I just don't feel like dealing with that. So I started working on my assignments like on my phone and stuff, but I really want to take a nap. Like, I just feel like I should take a nap because you guys know I woke up at 4 a.m, barely slept, then like, you know, went through sleep attacks and all that stuff. So I just feel like I should take a nap. Then when I wake up, I could like immerse myself in my work. But I've been doing what I can on my phone. It's just, you know, I'm tired, boss. And on top of that, y'all know I worked out, so your girl is mad tired. And not only that, y'all, but y'all know, like, I'm trying to unbig my back. In the midst of me unbigging my back, I'm also hurting my back. So, like, I have back pain right now. I'm like, bro, I'm only 23. Why am I going through all this stuff? Like, you know, but. Hey, guys. Hey, guys. So, I'm currently in a study room doing work. Y'all had to get out of my room because if not, I was just going to lay in my bed and watch Netflix. And that's what we're trying to not do. Remember, we're trying to change life. So, yeah, the more I was just, like, watching YouTube and stuff, I was getting inspired by the people I was watching. But, like, I literally was just like, girl, nothing's gonna happen if you just sit on your behind all day. So, we need to get up and go do something about it, you know? So, I'm here. I'm showing up. You know, I don't want to be here, but like I said, I want to change my life. So we're here, we're showing up, we're going to do the work. If you hear noise, there's a TV in front of me and SpongeBob is playing. So we're going to do work while we watch SpongeBob, okay? So yeah. All right, I'll check with you guys later.
This one I bet you will be jabbed. Me, I don't get tired.
Hey you guys, so I just submitted one assignment. Y'all, it was hard. You know, the assignment is not hard, but it was hard to actually like do the work because I did not feel like it, but I pushed through and managed to get one assignment done. But hey, that's better than nothing. So yeah, I'm about to leave here because that took a lot out of me to do. But we're about to go make dinner. We're gonna make tacos and guac. I'm gonna make some guac. I don't know if you guys know Aaliyah's face, but she's a content creator and she had made a guac recipe that I'm gonna try out tonight. So I'll let you guys know how that tastes and everything. But yeah.
Talk to me nice. Talk to me honestly.
A couple days later, well, like 2 days later. So basically, I guess we're continuing this vlog. I just left the hair store. I'm about to head back home. I have to finish my client's hair. We weren't able to finish yesterday because she ran out of hair, and by the time we ran out of hair, all the hair stores were closed. And since I had to come here anyway and re-up, I was like, I'll just get the hair for you. So yeah. But I'm about to go home and I'm gonna finish her hair. Y'all, we only got 9 braids left. But I'm gonna finish her hair and then I have homework to do, y'all, because I didn't do a lot of my homework. So yeah, because I have to do somebody's hair tomorrow. So I gotta finish all my homework today. Like, it's wild. But yeah, I'm gonna check in with you guys later. Just finished doing my client's hair and I kind of wanted to come on here just to like give an encouraging message or something, or like, I don't know, spread this little testimony or something. I don't know, I just feel like somebody could use this. So it blessed me and I wanted to bless you guys too. So pay attention, y'all, pay attention. I got tea. All right, so I've been watching Pastor Mike Jr. from Rock City Church in like Alabama, so I'll be watching his sermons and stuff. And then was it last week, not this past Sunday, but the week before last week, he was talking about, like, you know, honoring people and honoring God and honoring like the things that God has put in our life and like different areas of our life and stuff, right? So something he said that really stood out to me, he was like, when you don't honor it, it decreases, but when you do honor it, it increases. And as soon as he said that, I immediately thought about my business. Okay, so y'all know I'm a hairstylist. I do hair and stuff, right? But lately, for the past couple months, ever since I got my new job and stuff, I neglected doing hair a lot. And I kind of just like put it on the back burner because, like, okay, so I'll be working, going to school,
and stuff like that throughout the week. Like during the weekends, I just did not want to do hair. Like I just wanted to relax during the weekend and stuff. So like, and plus during the week, I didn't have time to do hair like that because I was either at work or I was at school. So like, you know, those things were like taking up space in my life. But God was still telling me like, you know, do hair. But I just kept saying like, God, I don't feel like it. Like I'm tired. I just want to rest on my weekends and stuff like that, right? So I would do hair like here and there. And even when I would do hair, I wasn't posting as frequently on my page as I usually would. And I felt like because of that, you know, I wasn't honoring my business like I normally would. Like I was a year ago, I wasn't honoring it as much. And because of that, I wasn't getting like a lot of clients and stuff. Like I was still getting clients, but not like as much as I'm used to and stuff. But when he said that, he was like, if you honor it, it'll increase. So I was like, man, it's the summertime. I'm on summer break from my job. Like, this is the perfect time to start, you know, doing hair again. I have the time. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna take it to heart. I'm gonna honor it and stuff. I started posting back on my thing, started, you know, coming up with a schedule to be consistent with it and everything. And just like trying to be consistent with my business. Y'all, it's been increasing, y'all. Like, I've been getting clientele. Like, I just finished somebody's hair, and literally, she just left because her sister came to pick her up. And right when she left, she literally texted me and was like, my sister said, can you do my hair too? Like, I was just like, wait a minute. Like, all these clients are, like, coming. Like, I'm getting new clients. I did somebody's hair yesterday, and she literally was like, you got yourself a new consistent client. And I was just like, look at God blessing me, you know? So I just want to tell somebody, like, yo, if it's something in your life that you're wondering why you're not increasing in it, or like why it's not going the way you want to, I just want you to ask yourself, are you actually honoring that area of your life? If you're not, then that's probably the reason why. So go ahead and honor it. All right, I'm gonna go finish cleaning up and stuff. But I just wanted to come in here and say that, because I just feel like somebody might need to hear that, you know? Like, I'm a living testimony. It's true, y'all. So with that being said, girl, I'm finna go be that girl and honor these other areas of my life, because we need some increase. Period.
That's 100.
Has been to empower you to live by principles and not by pressure. To live by principles and not by pressure, because oftentimes pressure shows up to expose what's really inside of you. And pressure will either bust a pipe, or pressure will either make diamonds. Now watch this, because it's important to remember that principles are pre-decisions. And oftentimes we wait until we're under pressure to make a decision. But when you have principles, the decisions are already made. If you decide what's right ahead of time, you will decide what's right at the time. Do I need to say that again?
Hey guys, so, okay, well, I see they're trying to upgrade here. But anyways, guys, we're heading to Five and Below because I need to get a protector screen for my phone, because I don't want it to fall and crack, you know? It is very hot. But you know, hell is hotter. So, yeah. But I'll check in with you guys later. Yeah. It's like 2 days later. Today's Tuesday, June 27th. So yeah, I just wanted to come up on here and give you guys a little update. So basically, I'm on a fast right now, but my fast ends today at 12:10 p.m. So me and my sister are gonna go to Kiki's Breakfast Cafe and get some food, because your girl is hungry, okay? But yeah, but we pushed through. We successfully completed this fast. I couldn't eat for 3 days, but yeah, but we're good. So yeah, I just wanted to kind of update you guys on that. I was like, God, I'm gonna treat myself. One, because you know, we fasted, and two, today is my 2-year anniversary with my business, so I'm gonna celebrate that as well. So yeah. Oh, and for those of you who don't know what fasting is, it's basically like giving up something to grow closer to God. Kind of like, it doesn't have to be food, but in this case, this is what God called me to do. But like, you can give up social media, you can give up candy, like whatever you really desire. Like if you choose to just sacrifice that just to like get closer to God and stuff. So yeah, there's probably more information about it, but yeah, that's basically what it is. So yeah, you know, we're trying to grow closer to God. So homie called me on the fast and I had to do it. I had to obey. So yeah, today is also gonna be the last day I record for this vlog, because I want to get this up and stuff. But yeah, after we're done eating, I have some errands to run. Like I have to go to Target, Walmart, Five Below, because I need to return that case I got. I didn't like how it looked on my phone, so I'm gonna return that. But yeah, I have to go to Target, Walmart and stuff. I need to get some necessities, because at the end of this week, I'm gonna be going out of town and I'm gonna go see Valerie. So yeah, I'm gonna go hang out with her for a few days and stuff, and you know, I'm gonna vlog and all of that, because we're trying to be consistent on this channel. But yeah, so I just wanted to check in and let you guys know what's up. Oh, I'm also taking out my hair today, y'all. We got to, because it's time to take it out, okay? So yeah, but I'm gonna check in with you guys later, maybe when we go to Kiki's or something. But I just wanted to let you guys know what was up. Alright. Hey guys. So we left Kiki's. Your girl is full.
Okay.
Period. But now we're at Walmart, because I'm gonna get some stuff.
Relax.
Okay. Or like I said, because I'm going out of town, so I'm gonna get some stuff.
Relax.
And we're gonna hit up Target later in the day, because girl, it's hot right now. Okay, so yeah. Hey you guys, so I just arrived to Target. It's the next morning. Y'all, I took out my hair. I have so much to update you guys on, because I know I was gonna end the vlog yesterday, but we're gonna do it today. But yeah, we're at Target and we're gonna pick up some stuff, but I have to update y'all. Y'all, did y'all know that they make these now? The spray-on sunscreen for black girl sunscreen? I'm thinking about getting it, because I don't know what I saw on someone's YouTube video where they bought like sunscreen to put on their face, and then they bought a spray on for the rest of their body. And I think that's a smart idea, because girl, I do not have the money to be running out. Oh, hold on, I need to get some lotion. All right you guys, so I left Target, but I wanted to give you guys an update on what happened yesterday. So basically, y'all know how I said I went to go eat because I broke my fast, right? Y'all, tell me why I ate. My body was not having it. And because we were walking in the sun and stuff, y'all, I experienced so many things. When I got home, I felt like I was about to faint. My body was not having it. I literally had to lay on the bathroom floor to keep myself from fainting. And one of my AirPods fell in the toilet. So yeah, that's my life. So I just want to say to anyone who's fasting, when you break off your fast, please start off slow with eating. Like, I knew that already, and this is not the first time this happened to me, but like, I ain't wanna, you know, but I learned my lesson. I ain't doing it no more. But no, like, start off slow when you break off your fast, okay? Because, yeah, we don't need to, yeah, but I just wanna say that. I even forgot to tell y'all that another reason why I was gonna faint was because, one, being in the hot sun, and then my hair, it was so heavy on my head, I literally took the scissors and started cutting. I had to take out my hair. It was ridiculous, but yeah. Hey you guys, so I made it home and I wanted to do a haul with y'all. So the things I got from Walmart and the things I got from Target. So let's get into it. So first up, Walmart. I had to re-up on some paper towels for like my bathroom and stuff, so I got two of those. I also got some Lysol wipes, cause you know, we gotta be clean over here. I got a pack of toothbrushes. I re-upped on my face wash because your girl ran out. So yeah, I'm using Cetaphil. I also got some mousse because I have a client later on today and tomorrow. And you know, I like to put this after I'm done doing their hair. I also got a toothbrush holder and stuff. I got this Pond's face moisturizer. I've heard good things about this. So I tried the red one, and when I tried that, that wasn't reacting well with my skin, but I've heard good things about this one, so I'm gonna test this out and see how that goes. And then I got some body oil. So I heard we're supposed to be going to the beach or something, so I don't know, put it on. So yeah, that's Walmart. Now let's get into Target. I got some tissues for my prayer closets, cause girl, I be crying when I be in the spirit, okay? I got the Black Girl sunscreen for kids because this is cheaper, cause we on a budget, okay? The other one is cool and all, but I didn't even see it, like the regular one, so I just got the kids one, and it's like significantly cheaper, so yeah. But I also got the spray on one because, like I said, you know, I want to use it on my body and use that on my face, especially since we're going to the beach, but for everyday use, you know, because like I said in my last vlog, your girl got sunburned and we're not trying to get that happen again this summer. So yeah, I got that too. I also re-upped on toothpaste because yeah, I was running out. I also got some mouthwash. I've got a tongue scraper thingy, and then I got the hair oil. Y'all, that whole hairstyle I just had, I did not moisturize my hair not once. I did not oil my scalp not once, and my hair is definitely dry, and this definitely grows my hair, so I needed to re-up on that. So yeah, that's everything that I got. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end the vlog here. That's it for this vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye. You change overnight. You out of sight.